Good evening, all of you. Welcome to the video lecture part 2 on the torsion of the shafts. In the previous lecture, we have seen how the FE formulation is to be done for the torsion of the circular shaft. In this lecture, we shall continue the problems on the basis of the derivation which we have solved in the previous lecture. First question, a solid stepped bar of circular cross section shown in the figure, it is subjected to a torque of 1 kilo Newton meter at its free end and a torque of 3 kilo Newton meter at its change in cross section section. Determine the angle of twist and shear stress in the bar. Take Young's modulus is equal to 2 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square. And the modulus of rigidity G as 7 into 10 raised to 4 Newton per mm square. So the figure is given, which is have a stepped shaft, okay, consist of two elements. One element has a 200 mm length and second element has 400 mm length of different cross sectional area, that is 100 mm and 50 mm respectively. And the loading that is also given, 3 kilo Newton meter and 1 kilo Newton meter, and both are in an anti-clockwise direction. So in the previous lecture we have mentioned that if the given moment, that is twisting moment, is in the anti-clockwise direction, then the effect has to be taken as positive sign. So first step is FE model. So model the FE of this section as a 1D bar element consist of two elements, because load is given here, so we need to consider two elements, one of 200 mm length and second is of 400 mm in length. So in the previous lecture we have derived the stiffness matrix for a circular shaft, that is here K is equal to GJ by L 1 minus 1 minus 1 1, where K is nothing but a stiffness matrix, G is nothing but modulus of rigidity, J as a polar moment of inertia, and L being the length of the element. So here we have two elements, we need to make or determine the two element stiffness matrix. Okay, so first stiffness matrix K1 is equal to G1 J1 by L1 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. So just substitute the formulas. Here G is given 7 into 10 raised to 4, and J1, how to find J1? That is pi d raised to 4 by 32. Whenever a circular shaft is given, the moment of inertia I can be determined by the formula pi d 4 by 64. Okay, when you want to find I, then it is pi d 4 by 64, and when it is to find J, that is polar moment of inertia, you have to divide it by d by 2, or the equation becomes pi d 4 by 32, just the half of the moment of inertia, you can say. Pi d 4 by 64 is I, pi d 4 by 32 is J. So you have the diameter of 100 mm. So now pi d raised to 4 by 32 will give you this value. Directly this value is given. So this value will come from J value, that is pi d 4 by 32, and L being the length of the element. So if you simplify this, then you will get this matrix consist of 3.44. Now similarly, elemental stiffness matrix for the second element, again G2. G is same actually, for the whole section G is same, hence take the same value of G, but J, due to the variation in the geometry of the given figure, J varies. Okay, so here pi into 50 raised to 4 by 32 will give you this value. Again it is calculated directly, and L is nothing but 400 mm, this one. So 1 minus 1 minus 1 1 as it is. If you simplify this value, you will get 10 to the power 9, 0.107, and this matrix. So you know how to number these matrix. That is, element 1 consists of node 1 and node 2. Hence here 1, 2 and 1, 2. Element number 2 consists of node 2 and 3. Hence 2, 3, 2, 3 here. So now if you assemble this matrix, these two matrix, then you will get the global stiffness matrix K. Okay. You know how to assemble, which is very similar as in the truss, beams and bars. Same procedure you need to apply and then assemble this. And we know the equilibrium equation, that is K into theta is equal to torque. In the previous lecture we have derived this K theta is equal to torque. Hence now you have a K, you have a theta. How many theta values are there? See, theta 1, theta 2, theta 3. Because there is a 3 possible and angular deflection possible. Hence you need to take 3 values. Okay. In the earlier problems we need to denote F1 X1, F2 X2, F3 X3. Same way here, instead of F, instead of force, here twisting moment is present. Hence theta T1 theta 1, T2 theta 2, T3 theta 3 you have to take. Okay. So now K into theta is equal to T, that is torque values. Okay. KQ is equal to F, you had written in the same way. Here K theta is equal to torque. So how many torque values are given? 2 torque values are given. At node 1 there is no torque. At node 2 we have a 3. At node 3 we have a 1 kilonewton meter. So just put these values. Okay. And now apply the boundary condition. So this question is very very similar to the bar problem. Same thing. Only change is the formulas. Okay. The procedure, rest of the procedure remains same. Okay. Now apply the boundary condition. Here node 1 is fixed. Hence eliminate first row and first column. You will get only 2 rows and 2 columns. Okay. Next. By solving this with the help of your calci, 2 equation, 2 unknowns, find the theta 2 as well as theta 3. So that value is will be theta 2 is equal to 1.162 into 10 to the power minus 9 radians. Remember, theta 2 angle, it is in radians, not degree. Remember that. And theta 3 is also in radians. Okay. The first topic is over, that is finding the deflections or the angular deflections. Second is what? The torque values and shear stress values. Okay, shear stress value. So in the previous lecture, at the last, I have written the shear stress formula. That is GR by L minus 1 1 theta 1 theta 2. Use that formula. Okay, this may get confused. Okay, sometimes he has written theta 1 theta 2 and some other time he has written theta 2 theta 1. So in order to avoid the confusion, refer the formula which I had written in the previous lecturer. Okay, at the last derivation I have written the formula for shear stress. Okay, that is GR by L minus 1 plus 1 theta 1 theta 2. So just multiply this. Okay, GR by L minus 1 into theta 1 is 0 and theta 2 into 1 is theta 2 only. So that theta 2 value is here. So you just multiply this, you will get the shear stress value, that is 20.3 Newton per meter square. I hope this point is clear. Similarly, here to find the shear stress in the second element, we have GR by L minus 1 plus 1. Now here is theta 2 theta 3. Okay. So he has mistaken here. Okay. You have to write theta 2 theta 3. Okay. Then it will be easy for you to solve this problem. Okay. So theta 2 minus theta 3. So just multiply this, you will get the tau 2 values. So if you are having a problem in this, what you do is put the formula like this. See, here it is given in the page number 3.44, it is there. In this way you write the formula, you will get it very easily. Okay. So this tau 2 value will be 40.85 Newton per meter square. So please concentrate on the units that plays a very important role. Okay, so make a note of it. When to put a Newton, when to put Newton mm, that way you need to cross verify and then you go for the solutions, right? Fine. So this is about the question number one. Question number two we'll see in the next video.